गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, इन चैप्टर 3 आई हैड एक्सप्लेन टाइप्स ऑफ फ्रेजेस इन माय प्रीवियस वीडियो. नाउ यू हैव टू राइट डेफिनेशन ऑफ काइंड्स ऑफ फ्रेजेस इन योर फेयर कॉपी विद नीट एंड क्लीन हैंडराइटिंग. नाउ First of all, you have to write date, chapter number, chapter name. Then start writing. There are mainly 5 different kinds of phrases based on different parts of speech. Come to the kind of phrase, noun phrase. A group of words that does the function of a noun in a sentence is called a noun phrase. Example, his sudden resignation upset everyone. Here, his sudden resignation is a noun phrase. Okay, come to the second sentence. A 50-year-old man was sitting in the garden. Here, 50-year-old. 50-year-old is noun phrase. Now, adjective phrase. A group of words that does the function of an adjective in a sentence is called an adjective phrase. Example, Hitesh is a man with strange habit. Here, with strange habit is adjective phrase. This, come to the second sentence. This chain is made of gold. Here, made of gold, adjective phrase. Come to the third kind, adverb phrase. A group of words that does the function of an adverb in a sentence is called an adverb phrase. Example, listen, beta, you have to write both examples of all kinds, okay? They lived in villages once upon a time. Here, once upon a time is adverb phrase. Come to the second example. Please keep the chemicals in the storeroom. Here, in the storeroom is adverb phrase. Now, verbal phrase. A verbal phrase consists of any of the 3 non-finites. Non-finites, infinitive, participle and gerund, and its objects or modifiers. Look at example. You are studying to pass your board examination with good marks. Here, to pass your board examination with good marks is verbal phrase. Now, come to the second example. He enjoys playing cricket in the evenings. Here, playing cricket in the evening is verbal phrase. Now, 5 prepositional phrase. A prepositional phrase consists of a preposition, its objects, and any modifiers of the object. These phrases add descriptive details. to a sentence. For example, they are having meeting in the conference room. Here, in the conference room is prepositional phrase. Come to the second example. Employees are advised to be on time. Here, to be on time, on time is prepositional phrase. You have to write this in your fair copy. Okay? Now, clause Now come to the clause. Clause is a group of words that contains a subject and a verb. It can be a complete sentence in itself, or it can be a part of a larger sentence. Larger sentence. Try to understand by this example. Examples. He came to visit me. To visit me last evening. He came to visit me last evening. Beta, no need to write these examples. Okay, I will give you written word in my next video. Here, in this example, the part He came is clause because it contains a subject linked to a verb. Okay, look at another example. I called my aunt because she is unwell. In this sentence has two verbs, called and unwell. Called and is. So there are also two subjects for these verbs, I and she. This sentence therefore has two clauses. I called my aunt. And second is because she is unwell. Okay. Every sentence is a clause because every sentence has a subject and a verb. But every clause is not a sentence because every clause may not make complete sense. I called my aunt is a clause as well as a sentence as well as a sentence. Because it has a subject and verb and make complete sense. However, because she is unwell is a clause with a subject and a verb. Subject and a verb. But it is not a sentence because it does not make complete sense by itself. No need to write anything about clause today. It is to make you understand. Only write types of phrases, definition and example. Revise your clause. This is your homework. Okay? Thank you.